Hey, Viking singers, this is the first episode of Cook in the Kitchen. This is Cook, here's our kitchen, and here are the other cooks in the kitchen. We've got Addison, say hi. And we've got Mrs. Cook, and today we're going to be making spaghetti carbonara. So it comes from this recipe book, The Essentials of Italian Cooking. If you ever find it at a thrift store, it is really awesome. Here's what you'll need. You will need 1 pound of pasta, spaghetti. You'll need Parmesan cheese. You'll need bacon, about 1/2 pound. I have about 7 slices there. 2 eggs, salt, pepper, and garlic. Super easy recipe that makes a really, really fancy meal. So we'll get started by boiling some water. Just go ahead and put it on high heat. I usually add a pinch of salt and then put the pasta in, and then we'll start frying up some bacon. Yum, yum. So spaghetti carbonara came from Italy right after World War II, and it was said that all these soldiers were in Italy after World War II, and they wanted a dish that reminded them of home. So the Italians put together a pasta dish that involved bacon and eggs, which is kind of where the sauce and some of the crispy comes from in this pasta. So what I'm doing now is just chopping this bacon into a dice. So what it looks like is about like this. You want the bacon big enough to kind of fry up, but small enough so that it can get really crispy all around. So that's what I'm doing. Then I'm going to put it in the pan, let it cook and get crispy, and move on to the next step. So here's what I've got going. I put the pasta in the pan. It cooks for about 10 minutes. In the other pan, I put 4 pieces of garlic, which is just getting a good brown. And once it's brown, I'll take it out. It's just giving some of the flavor of garlic into some olive oil that I've also put in that pan. But it's about ready to come out. So I'll go ahead and take that out. And while I take that out, you'll also be able to see that I've got my bacon cut and ready to go. It's just living right there. And I'm gonna put that into the pan right now. So the pan's pretty hot. Yeah, in fact, it's probably too hot. You hear all that sizzling. It means that you're in a good place. You don't need to be any hotter than that. There's the bacon crisping up. So I'm just gonna watch that. Got my pasta boiling. I'll shred my cheese while all that's working, and I'll see how Addison's doing with her dinner.
Woo! Addison, doing okay? Yeah.
And the Cook family is getting ready to eat. Hey, quick tip. I'm in the middle of grating cheese, and I just wanted you to know, you should get the block of cheese from the grocery store. Don't get the shaky stuff in the can. That's like really good for the top of pizza, but this is the real deal, and this is what's going to make the pasta super tasty. So to use the grater, you just hold it up at an angle and take your little block of cheese, the fresh stuff, and then you just grate like this. So you want about 1/2 cup of that, and this is the secret to making a really, really great creamy pasta. All right, it's go time. I'm taking my pasta, gonna drain it in the sink, and then get the sauce ready in just a couple minutes. So here's that pasta. It's been about 10 minutes. I can tell that it's done because there's no raw pasta in the middle. Like if I bite in and look at the middle of the pasta, it's not white anymore, but it's all cooked through. So here we go. Taking the pasta to the sink. Should have thought about this first. Getting my strainer, which a real chef would have had ready to go in the sink. But clearly I'm not a real chef, I'm just a cook. And so here's what I've got. Got my pasta, got the strainer in the sink, dump it out. Perfect. Now I'm going back to the bowl. And I've got my cheese ready to go. Got the bowl, so I'm gonna put that cheese in. I've got my 2 eggs. That egg is going to form the sauce for this pasta, which may sound weird, but it's actually super tasty. So just cracking those eggs, putting them in the bowl. Addison's excited about everything. I'm also gonna give a grind of pepper. A liberal ground of pepper. Now I've got all that ready to go. So now I just kind of whisk it up. Got my whisk. Whisk. That's it. Once I've got that whisked, now I just need to add the pasta. That's going to kind of combine with the egg and harden the egg up into a sauce. So here's the pasta in the sink. There's the addition. And now I'm just gonna mix, and I'll show you the finished products when I finish mixing. Final step, I've mixed everything together. You can see it's in the bowl. The bacon's looking all crispy and tasty. I just dumped it in the pan after I mix everything up. And final tip, I use these tongs when I'm mixing up pasta because it just is a little easier to work with. Now I just need to take a big old scoop. Put it right in the middle of this bowl. And I'll add a couple more scoops. That meal is ready for the cooks and for you too, I hope. So there it is, a little spaghetti carbonara. At the end, I'll just put a little bit of salt and a little bit of pepper on top, and it'll be good to go.